Caffeinated Apes here, Kyle.
And Heather.
Find us on our website, thecaffeinatedapes.com.
Mm-hmm.
I felt like playing that song because I feel motivated.
I feel motivated. Wow.
Got some interaction, and I felt motivated, and I caved under the pressure. And so I released a part two to our cliffhanger.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody is now very happy, eager.
And now they know.
Yep, now they fucking know.
Now they know the legend.
of the fucking mighty Sascock. That's right. Oh, wait. Okay, wait.
The Sascock.
Why was that sounding like a question?
Don't ever do that again. No, that was great. That was more scary than my fucking.
This is not very scary. You were scary.
Just kidding. Anyway, what do we got? We got some shit.
You know, we wanted to do this reaction video, but we decided that it really wasn't worth it.
Yeah.
So we'll just tell you, it was a video about some methed out lady who there was a traffic stop, and it was for like brake light being out or something like that.
It's so stupid, man. Tail light. It's so stupid. Mm-hmm. It's so fucking stupid.
She's the passenger. So what started, it started badly anyway, but what turned it worse was he asked her to put her cigarette out because her infant was in the back seat.
Yep.
And he, you know, it's right in his face.
Too. Yeah. Just, yeah. He's trying to plead to her heartstrings of like, hey, you know, stop being such a shitbag here.
She said, well, you stopped me. It was fine because the window was open and we were moving before. Now it's all his fault that the baby's getting secondhand smoke.
Well, duh. Shocked. Duh. And what did she think of that?
Well, she put her cigarette out, but she flicked it right in his face.
Right. In his fucking face, and that's not what you do on traffic stops, folks.
You don't get to stay in the car after that.
No, police officers don't like that very much. Mm-hmm. You get yanked out of the car, and this nice lady resisted.
What did I do?
Oh, my God, man. She resisted arrest the whole way, including after being tasered. I forgot what it was called.
Yeah, so what I was going to call this segment was Sig Taser Diaper.
Ooh.
Because the officer actually, this is all on body cam video footage, man. Which we hope to actually do some of this someday.
I think she wants to be on the video, but she wants to be the police officer.
I want to be the police officer.
Yeah, you want to be the stunner.
Not the dumbass.
You want to be the stunner, the shooter, or the pepper sprayer. Mm-hmm. You're down for that.
Yeah, I'm going to restore some order.
You are a hungry tigress when we're watching those shows.
So anyway, but the baby had a very full diaper because all three people that were in the car had to be removed. And I don't know about the female that was in the back seat.
Yeah, along with everybody got arrested as far as I remember.
So that part sucked. But the officer was very kind. You could tell he had kids. It was very cute.
Absolutely, I didn't think anything was, you were very impressed by it. I expected nothing less, you know, in all honesty. Cool. It's very cool. It's very cool
but
shit.
You like, so Kyle the Explorer here, like you were first exposed to the inner workings, if you will, the blue side.
Oh, I started telling you about this, didn't I?
Yeah, you did.
Oh, man.
So like...
Back in the Wild West. 1988-ish.
Yeah. You were how old?
I was about 17.
Okay.
Yeah. And I was a police explorer scout on my way to police officerdom. I was trajectoried in that direction. And by a person that I spent a lot of riding time with. You know, you're supposed to diversify yourself to get exposed to all different types of different people and shit. And Crazy Dave and I totally clicked, man, like right off the bat.
Crazy Dave.
Yep, Crazy Dave is what we're going to go with, Crazy Dave.
Was he like your age?
Oh, God, no. No, he was
not 17, obviously. But.
So I'm not sure how old he would be. He passed away. I'm not sure how old he would be right now. But in 88, he was a Vietnam vet with a tank division.
So 70s?
Yeah, he was probably. No. I'm trying to think. I'm not sure. He'd be up there.
40s,
yeah, bare minimum. 50s. Like, oh, back then. Yeah, 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 for sure.
Okay.
No, he was a fucking maniac, though. He fucking trusted me so much at 17 that he would be like, okay, man, look, if any shit goes down, you better fucking come running with that shotgun, you know. And he'd make sure I knew where like this little secret fucking button was to unlock it, and he'd make me unlock it and show him I could get it out and everything. And I'm thinking, fuck yeah.
Is that normal?
I certainly don't believe so, no.
Like,
any other
kid that would have been in your shoes would not have. What was it? What was it?
Like, what was it that that made him feel like he could do that?
Yeah.
I mean, maybe he would have done that for anybody. I don't know. He seemed to have a lot of trust in me. Probably just, I was like an old soul, man.
We already had your Mossad training.
By then I had definitely Mossad training. I was ready for action. I was hoping that, I was so hoping shit would go down most of the time, but, one time it did actually. And I was fucking, I knew it, man. I'm like, this is it. I'm going to be the hero. Dun, dun, dun. I'm going to fucking kick that door open. I'm going to shoot three motherfuckers and like save the day. I know.
Save the pretty girl.
Fuck,
save,
man.
Princess Peach.
I was going to get like a presidential medal is what I was picturing.
The key to the city.
Yep. So like, as every time he left me in the car, it was, you know, it was pretty fucking serious. And I, you know, when he would let me get out and do shit, it was not around other fucking police officers. You know, it was not kosher to be having a 17-year-old doing the shit I was doing. There's no fucking way, man. Like, one time I'm like, Dave, I want to do a traffic stop. He's like, okay. Like, that easy. And where we were at, he goes, all right, find a reason to pull that fucking car over, and I'll pull over, you do this traffic stop. I'm like, fuck, yeah, right. I go, okay, so, you know, I made up some bullshit about that stuff I was told you about, like the license plate light.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Like, I couldn't see it.
Yeah.
Like, you know, I couldn't see the light. It was at night.
It's a technicality.
This was at night, by the way. Fucking shitbag car, middle of fucking nowhere. He just goes, he pulls him over. I push all the buttons to make the lights activate, everything. I fucking radio dispatch, calling them, telling them the fucking so-and-so unit's making a fucking traffic stop. And he just opens the, like, he's like, all right. And he opens his door just to sit there. And I walk up, and like two steps before I hit the driver's side window, it fucking hit me. It fucking hit me, the seriousness of the situation, that like,
I might not go home tonight.
Well, yeah, because I'm like, I have no gun.
Right.
Like, I have no fucking gun. I had a pair of handcuffs and a pocket knife is what I had, man, right? Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Thank God. Literally, thank God. It was like a 20-something-year-old lady on her way home. I took her driver's license, registration, proof of insurance, radioed it, radio dispatch from me standing outside the fucking car window. They think I'm standing there with Crazy Dave doing all this shit. He's just back in the car, probably not even looking at me, probably reading the paper or some shit. I don't even know.
With his flask.
Fuck, man. Maybe. Now, we'll say he never drank around me, but that did not. Then just he probably thinking didn't. About some of this
I'm
shit,
just
man.
Talking shit.
Yeah, no, I don't know.
It's probably not very cool.
Fucking shit talker. He was Irish, though, so anyway. But I was like, I didn't want to finish the traffic stop to end the short story quickly. Mm-hmm. I got what I asked for, and I realized, and he asked afterwards, too. He's like, let's go do another one. I'm like, nah, I'm good. You know, because he knew I, like, he could not give me a gun and say, go do traffic stop.
Right.
And he was willing to let me fucking risk it all, I guess, to learn my lesson.
Which was?
Don't be too big for your britches was a good lesson, I would say, that I learned that day. Now, not that I didn't think that I could handle anything that took place or went down, just, you know, being arrogant and cocky and just knowing what I knew.
Young.
And exactly. That didn't make it okay. So don't do that, kids. You don't get to do that as a police explorer scout. It does not happen. And everything And I mean, everything is all entertainment and comedy, and I've made up all these stories, 100%. All my stories are made up. Oh, my God, there's a bug in here. Okay, anyway. Let's move it on.
Moving on.
Fucking Dave. I miss that guy.
Man.
The other guy that has a two-letter name we don't mention also misses him, by the way.
I bet.
I promise he does.
You know, the way we've kind of rebranded ourselves recently.
Yes.
You know, if some of our longtime listeners may know, we really try getting kind of political.
We dipped our toe in it, yeah. Didn't feel good.
No, it felt really like it. Bad. It was very stressful and toxic. Very toxic because we don't really know anything.
No,
even if we studied it, we still don't know because what's anyway.
Exactly.
Anyway,
it just seemed like the more we learned, the more we questioned, the more we thought we didn't believe anybody or anything. Right. So we're like, this is just too toxic. We're just going to make people laugh instead.
Yeah, because we really just wanted to make the world a better place. We wanted to help because it's fucking scary right now.
Exactly. We were ready to be citizen journalists, man. Mm-hmm. But you know what?
Go to Maui. And
it's not easy being cheesy.
No, we still have our beliefs and we're more than happy to discuss them. We're still going to mention things with you. Yes. But we're not going to make it a...
It's not our mission.
It's not our mission.
No, it's
like
not our
mission.
Like
he said, we just want to make you laugh.
Oh, shit. I'm so sorry. That was the wrong button.
Entertain you.
Apologize.
Make you happy, you know?
Exactly. We want to spread peace, love, and happiness.
Peace, love, and raunchiness.
Fuck yeah, man.
Because we are all about that locker room life.
Do we have any more Saucecock stories? I don't think I have any more.
I don't think
well,
so.
I was eating that mic right there.
Well, locker room life. You did tell me about somebody in our local... the gym that we used to go to, who was a bit of a sasscock.
You didn't discuss this one before the show with me.
So we don't need to say who.
The reason I'm laughing so hard is because it's so fucking funny, man, to me, that somebody with such artwork, such a masterpiece.
And a six pack,
by the way, at their age. And I think they just, they're like Mr. Miyagi. I'm not even joking, man. I think he goes home.
Oh shit. Yeah.
He lifts weights. He goes to work. He lifts weights to be physical, like karate. And then he fucking trims his bonsai trees and, reads and fucking studies philosophy in his pastime. I don't even know. I mean, but I'm jealous of this motherfucker.
He's single, ladies, or gents, or whatever.
Whatever. Anybody that listens to this that knows me from those days will go, oh, him. Yep.
Yeah.
Because totally. I made sure everybody knew. Because I'll tell you what, one thing you're not going to keep hidden around me if I see it is a sasscock. Like the more people you tell, the better. In fact, I feel.
Because you know what? When we were growing up, we didn't know such things existed.
No.
You know
what?
Man. Our parents didn't talk about that.
No.
Right?
There wasn't. Look, I don't remember my parents ever talking to me about sex ed ever. In fact, I tried to ask once, and it was. Oh, my God.
I always love it when I can tie things into one of our favorite shows.
You have won, and on that note, we're going. No, just kidding.
No.
No, I'm just kidding.
So sorry, I totally derailed you.
Oh my God, that was so great. Anyway. That was such a fucking good reference, man. That's exactly who that is, by the way. Mm-hmm. Ted Hitchcock. Just kidding. There's a show, Shorzy, that we watch, and there's a character on there.
Ted Hitchcock.
But his name in the show
was Ted. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Anyway, something like that. Yeah. I don't even remember what I'm talking about anymore. You're over there going, you better shut the fuck up.
Anyway, Letter Kenny, check it out.
Yes, we recommend watching it at least
Canadian
once.
Humor. Yeah.
We've watched all the seasons, I think.
More than that.
Four times?
Way more. Yeah.
Four times.
It's
at
like
least.
A good comfort show.
Oh, it's so. Look, you got to just relax and go with it. Just relax and go to it.
Okay, so parents didn't talk about that either. But, you know, and this isn't a slam on my parents or anything. It just wasn't, you had sex ed in school.
Yeah.
Is what you did. That your parents didn't tell you jack shit.
No. Oh, I was going to tell you about when I asked.
It wasn't their job.
I was going to tell you about when I asked. It was first ask your mother. And then when I asked my mother, it was you'll learn that in college. That's the answer I got. Yeah.
I think that's a really common one. You'll learn that in college, son. That's been in some movies,
for
right?
For my age bracket, I mean, I think that's totally.
Yeah. Yes, the good old days.
Yep, the good old days. By the way, I got, I'm trying to think, the 24, our 24-year-old daughter that lives out of town told me that she thought our show was really funny. And that she didn't need to know about my first ever porn rental.
Well, then she's really going to like the next.
Right? Oh, man. I just put up the emoji with the like, hey.
It's only going to get worse. I promise you.
That's why. Oh, I also ran into our gentleman that's going to be doing some work for us.
Nice. Okay.
When I was shopping and spent the fucking amount of money. I still don't understand. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I walk up. I'm like, hey, I'm Kyle with Caffeinated Apes. It's not really how I did it, but I went up and introduced myself again. And then he goes, we were both just like, man, I said, dude, I really I'm looking forward to sitting down and talking with you. Mm-hmm. And I said, have you watched or listened to any of the show? And he's like, not yet, but he said, Heather sent me something. I'm not sure what you sent him.
I think it was the clip.
Oh, maybe. That's perfect, actually.
Well, like the very first thing we sent everybody because we were so excited.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. Yeah.
So
yeah,
we're really looking forward to working with this dude. And when we know more, we'll definitely share more.
Oh, man. But, it's going to be nice to get some artwork done. Art. I mean, we can't do everything. It's like, fuck, man.
He's so cool.
We're going to get a better logo. And it's just, I can't fucking wait. Yeah. Can't wait. Heather's going to start printing some shirts for me left and right.
Yeah. No, well, what? Okay. Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
Rewind. Reverse.
What do we got?
Well, gosh. So I had like thinking about back in the day, sex ed. Not only that, but we read books because we didn't, have the internet. So I guess encyclopedias, you can learn a bunch of shit. Books like the V.C. Andrews, Flowers in the Attic.
Okay, series. So no, I don't think those books were
a little
bit
of incest romance.
As I said, I wish I was privy to those books. I don't think I can say that. That's weird.
No.
Weirdo. I'm just kidding. I don't think boys know about those books as much
probably
as girls
not.
Do
it
back in the
then.
Day.
Yeah. It was just a series about these poor kids that had to go live with their grandmother, maybe.
Was this like a book?
They were the product of
inbreeding. Yeah. I'm familiar with the story. Oh. What... how did you come by these books?
Library.
So you were just like, did someone recommend it, or did you hear about it in some capacity?
It was probably maybe displayed, or just, I mean, I was a vicarious reader, so if it was there, I was gonna
I remember
read
seeing
it.
Books.
And maybe I had heard about it. I had a friend, you know, maybe my friend Brandy had already read the books and told me about it, because I do believe she really liked them.
I remember overhearing girl folk talk about reading books back then, that boys would be like, whatever, man. Just show us your boobs.
I remember in eighth grade health class, we had this weird, earlier we were talking like the poor substitute that seemed to always have to come in on the day that they were doing sex ed.
Man,
and
I bet
class,
they love that so much.
Yeah. And Mr. Ward, oh, bless him, man. Nicest guy, nice teacher. And one of these students smirkingly raises her hand. Anybody have any questions, you know? And you know, he's just going, please, no questions, please, come on. And she smirks and she said, Mr. Ward, can the little spermies live like in the stuff if it like lands on your stomach or something? Can they still live and can you still get pregnant from that?
Ooh, I bet he couldn't.
You know, not
wait
a bad question, really.
Question. I mean, look, there's no bad questions.
No, no.
Because if you don't know, then you don't fucking know.
I think he gave the correct answer there, but.
I bet he did, man.
I mean,
I bet
it
he
was
a
poor guy. Oh, man.
Do they do that? Do they still have a sex ed talk or whatever
in
school now?
I
feel like
there
how
was
could
some
they,
controversy recently over that in our school district, but I don't know if it's part of the curriculum still or not. Kenna says no.
I wouldn't think it's look, man. I wouldn't think it's needed. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't think it's needed because the internet. Mm-hmm. I mean, the fucking internet.
There should be a whole section on that, though. It should be.
There should be. Yeah. You know what? I'll bet you there's that in the curriculum of something.
We talk, they should know anyway.
Yes, they should know. With
the knowledge they have received.
Okay, moving on.
Okay. But they're kids.
They're kids. What do we got?
Okay, well, back in the day when we didn't have internet, fucking like we were talking. you know, we talked about the personal ads, like when you're an adult, you know, one way to meet people if you couldn't get on the dating show.
Yeah.
Be back in 2 and 2. How did we meet people, like between the ages of 16 and 20?
Oh, that's a good question.
Before that, it's like skating rink, I guess. That's a good question.
You know, I'm trying to think. So from 16 to 18, it was in school, definitely. I would think a lot of in school, but always trying to go to a party.
Sporting events.
Sporting events were always super like hopeful. I remember being in packs of hyenas. I mean, boys going to these things. literally like,
I can't wait to find her. Oh,
you know, just that kind of crazy shit going on. Mm-hmm. And that was the energy, you know, man. So I'm going to say, like you said, sporting events, dances, school, the skating rink, even from 16 to 18. And then from like 18 to, I guess, just before 21, that's where it gets sketchy in a small town, because there weren't a lot of avenues because...
Small town life.
Right. I mean, you had to hope for a party.
We had to drive 20 plus miles to go cruising to meet people that we didn't grow up with.
Right.
That's what we did. We went cruising. You get in your car and you drive and you see people. And
so there was an area that you would just kind of do laps, right? Mm-hmm. Like very similar probably to most places.
It was controlled and it was watched by
was there a main store or gas station or something that was the was kind of the hub? Do you remember what the hub was?
One of them was an arcade area, of course. That was a cool one. Yeah.
See that? Burger like a King movie, man.
Mm-hmm. That's where my car went through a store window one time.
Oh shit.
I wasn't driving it.
Still your fault.
Oh yeah. I actually she asked me to take the blame because her dad was in the army and she was like,
oh man,
you know, oh my god, poor thing. So I'm like, I tried, but there was a witness, and he's like, no.
Good. I'm
he
worked, glad
he was the manager at the arcade.
I'm glad overall.
Yeah, me too. But anyway, so there, and then another place, it was like a mall.
In the mall, people would go in the mall to hang out.
Sometimes, but it was like at night once the mall was closed. That whole area, four blocks or whatever, city blocks.
Okay, so the mall, in the town, you know, up there where the arcade is now, in the town up just up from us, the mall.
Oh yeah. Sorry, yeah. You're talking about now.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Is that okay? Well, I was just.
Yes.
Go. You finish.
The other place was on the beachfront, Alki.
Oh, or not Alki, okay.
But Ruston Way, Tacoma.
Ooh, which one was your favorite? If you had a favorite.
Man, they were all cool for different things.
Yeah,
Ruston was probably the coolest during the day, like for weekend cruising, daylight cruising. Mm. Ruston, that was like the fresh, like 2 miles an hour, so everybody sees you. That's how it felt on Ruston, because everybody was bumping too. So.
Yeah. Bumping. Oh my God, man. I remember the bumping days.
So what about the arcade place here?
Oh no, just the, at the time it was a very popular mall.
Yeah.
And I had forgotten about that being one of the spots that
was it?
The cars would hit after the mall closed type of thing. Well, the movie theater was there. So like the last movie, there'd be people fucking racing out of there with their fucking low riders and different shit. Camaros and stuff.
Yeah, just pull up and talk to people and find out where the party is. Usually, yeah.
The main the main hangout would have been Godfather's Pizza, which is where Pizza Hut is now, actually. But it was Godfather's Pizza, the back in the day Godfather's Pizza, and you would see cool picture in my head, like a bunch of muscle cars parked all out front. Like where the cars park now on the street, it'd be a bunch of muscle cars back then with their hoods up and shit, which was badass. And trucks also, people hanging around all the time. And inside, they kept it open until like 11 o'clock at night, I think. And that was a big deal for us.
Mm-hmm.
And it was always busy. They made a lot of money, I bet. They sold beer too, which that must have been fucking crazy with a bunch of kids running around at the same time.
Yeah,
I'm sure there was nobody giving away fucking beer. But that's about it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That was fun shit though. A lot of drag racing took place right in front of that place. A lot of fights, lot of guys hoping to pick up girls, but I always, man, not always, but like more times than not, the groups of guys seem to not pick up chicks. Mm. You know what I mean? Like everybody went home normally the same way they got there. Rarely did I ever see a fucking, the amount of hype that was talked into before these nights. Rarely did I
maybe
see.
Maybe you get a phone number though.
Maybe.
It was rare for us too, actually.
Well, people just didn't know how to fucking talk to one another. Nobody was brave enough to hardly say anything.
It would have been a lot different if texting.
Oh my God. You know? That, you know, that's something that I didn't think
that
about.
That would have been a decent combination, actually. Like if people could cruise now and be responsible, like if you're old enough to drive a car, you should be. Well, not that, just to not be a fucking asshole and trash the place, you know?
Yep. See, that's
or
the thing.
End up in a fight. Or, I mean, there was, this was actually, I'll just say where it was. This was up in Federal Way, like up SeaTac Mall back then. And there was gangs. That was like the height of the Crips and the Bloods. Oh, my God.
No, I know but what you area just, you're talking about the, when you were rolling.
Nothing ever happened.
No, it seemed like it seemed like it was a whole bunch of buildup for just bullshit. Yeah. Yep.
It was probably just propaganda.
Yeah. All right. What else we got?
Oh, my goodness. So
beat that horse, man.
Let's see. I know. I was going to say another place.
You just
place.
Can't stop talking about fuck. I'm just kidding.
No. When I got older, actually, my friend and I discovered the military base was a fabulous
scandalous
place to meet
man.
Dudes.
Yeah. Scandalous.
Yeah. And you could just call the main desk in whichever barracks you wanted to hit up and talk to somebody. And it's almost like mail order.
Can I just say
when's your shift over?
I'm pretty sure that a dude couldn't have been like, man, I'm really bored tonight. I'm going to call up the fucking front desk, man. Be like, hey, can you patch me through to just anybody over in whatever, you know?
No, you didn't do that.
Oh, tell me. Oh, okay.
So you would just talk to whoever answered the phone.
Oh, my God. Okay. It's even better, right?
Yeah.
Hey. Yeah. What are you guys up to, man? Who the fuck is this? This is Kyle. What the fuck do you want? I don't know. I'm bored, man. What are you guys doing? Fuck.
So and so there?
So different.
No.
Oh, you hussies. I know the game. Guys play that game too. Mm-hmm. Guys play that con too. Ah, shit. Wrong number. Fuck, you sound cool. Mm-hmm. Gee, I didn't. Yeah, I totally didn't do this on accidental purpose here.
Yeah. So there was a couple that the first time we did that, somebody came over and we freaked out and didn't answer the door and like ran and hid.
Oh, fuck like, yeah, dumb. Man.
What did you think was going to happen?
Right?
I mean, come on.
Hey, come on. You fucking sound the fucking alarm or the dinner bell. I'm sorry, the dinner bell.
I know.
Fucking
so we had to do it again.
Up.
We actually did meet some cool people.
No, of course.
I think. Our friend Chad, that actually ended up being a roommate for a while.
The Chad.
That might be how we met him, actually. Ooh. But there was a couple.
Are we going to get scandalous?
This falls under.
It was like 100 years ago, by the way.
Oh, God. Well, yeah.
Yeah.
More than that.
Go for it, girl.
So one of these times, this a nice dude that came over, but really there wasn't a ton of chemistry with either my roommate. With anybody.
Yeah.
I had a female roommate at the time.
Yeah.
And so we just kind of all passed out, went to sleep. Well, next thing I know, I wake up and he's in my bed.
Uh-oh.
And I didn't make him leave. I mean, I didn't want to be rude.
Wait. Hi. Yeah.
What you doing?
Are
just
want
to cuddle.
Are you awake? Yeah. Man, I'm kind of cold. I just cuddle a little bit. Yeah. I swear. Just a little bit of cuddling. That's all. I'm just going to I'm taking my pants off because, you know, like the heat transfer thing.
Yeah. Anyway, so go to sleep, wake up the next morning, find out my friend Lisa, he had also hit up her bed.
He wanted to snuggle with her too? Mm-hmm. Oh my God.
Same thing. She's
fucking
a nice girl.
Snuggle Rama.
She's
of course, man. Hey, look, you're allowed to live, you know, when you're fucking young.
So we did figure that one out. It didn't take long that next day. Mm-hmm. And he totally owned up to it. He's like,
okay, so that's even, look, you got to be like, that's cool.
Do you blame me?
Oh, good move.
Basically.
Good move. Truth usually helps.
Mm-hmm. And so then I had to take him back there the next day. Because I don't I don't know if he had a car. You know, a lot of boys, I mean, they didn't back then.
So, okay.
It's not like it is now.
No, that's true. Why would they need one? Mm-hmm. Honestly, I totally forget, piece of shit. Oh, wait, they don't need a fucking car. Yeah.
And I don't even know how long he had been in town. You know,
oh, my God. So would that be like a drive of shame? I mean, what the fuck, man?
No, so that next day is so happened.
No!
My mom had called me, and we were set to have like brunch the next morning.
Yeah.
So I just took him with us to brunch, and he met mom, and it was—I mean, it was a good afternoon. I never talked to him again, but it was a.
I will say, I'll bet he still talks about that.
Oh, probably.
That so it would have been like that weekend or that night.
Nothing stands out in my head about the encounter, so I'm thinking.
Well, other than after you,
right? But yeah. I'm like, oh, it's just a typical, you know, young adult.
Yep, just whatever. Hey, whatever, man. Exactly.
Waste of time.
Exactly. You can't get those 10.5 seconds
back. Memories.
No, I promise, man. He might still. If he doesn't talk about it, he thinks about it. Mm-hmm. Because there aren't many fucking, he's like, and brunch.
I know.
Like, his buddies are like, fuck you, man. No, her mom took us to fucking brunch, dude. Mm-hmm. I'm not even joking. Mm-hmm. All right, what else we got?
You know?
Are we ready to do it?
I think that's about it.
What?
Yeah.
No way. No way. You know what that means, people? That means Kyle doesn't get to play the microphone anymore. So don't forget to find us on thecaffeinatedapes.com. All one word. You can you can fucking email us too.
You might have to yell it.
thecaffeinatedapes@gmail.com. I think I said that right. Find us on YouTube, Facebook, X, formerly Twitter. What else? Anything else? You got a microphone? Anywhere else you can find
TikTok.
Us? TikTok. Find us on TikTok.
Instagram.
Yes. Hey, guess what? We love you.